Hey, I'm Brian. You may have heard a lot of buzz around something called Edge Functions lately. Well, in this video, I'm going to give you a very brief intro into what Edge Functions are, as well as show you how LaunchDarkly's Cloudflare integration lets you take advantage of Edge Functions to enable some really powerful capabilities in your application. So let's get started. Typical serverless backend exists in a single location or region geographically. This means that the end user may get latency due to the distance depending on where in the globe they're connecting from. Even a Jamstack or SSR application deployed to a CDN still has latency involved in calling the backend, which is typically still deployed to a single region. An edge function moves that backend serverless logic to an edge node or CDN. Calls to the backend from the client now hit the CDN node closest to the end user. However, edge functions also enable some interesting capabilities because they have the ability to intercept the call and modify or replace the request and/or response. One of the biggest providers of edge functions is Cloudflare. They have a service called Cloudflare Workers, which is effectively any serverless function on Cloudflare, except that they don't make a distinction between a regular serverless function and an edge function because every Cloudflare worker is an edge function. This is my Cloudflare dashboard. You can see I have a number of workers set up here already. What you're going to need, obviously, to connect with LaunchDarkly is a Cloudflare worker. You're going to need your account ID, which you can get here on the page here, as well as an API token, which you can click and create here. The last thing you're going to need, what LaunchDarkly's integration does, is it synchronizes flag data on our end with the KV within your worker. What that allows you to do is access that data directly at the edge where the KV lives, where the worker is. So you're going to need to create a KV here by going to create a namespace. This KV will be associated with your worker. We'll see how that works in a moment. To make the Cloudflare integration, you're going to go to integrations within your LaunchDarkly dashboard. You're going to add an integration here. I've already got one set up. We can take a look real quickly at what that looks like. I just give it a name. I can tie it to any environment, so I can have different KVs tied to different environments so that I can do testing of multiple environments with different worker setups. I put the account ID from Cloudflare in here that we talked about earlier, the KV namespace ID. So once I create that namespace, I get the ID and I paste it in here, as well as the API token. I can even validate that this connection works before moving on. This is a simple site I built using Cloudflare Workers. It has a couple of flags connected to it that change this header text and add an about section to the page. I'm going to go ahead and change those for us in a moment here. So we're going to say show about us, turn that to true. And then if you go back, you'll see that this about section is now showing. That's because this one runs as a client-side flag and does actually replace out those values there. The other one is this header text that we can change from LaunchDarkly says, hey, this one is being changed within the worker itself. So it's effectively like a server-side flag that changes to high from LaunchDarkly. This is connected to this particular KV here. We can actually go into the KV and you'll see the entry. You can view and see the flag data that's being synchronized from LaunchDarkly within my KV that's connected to that Cloudflare worker. Let's finally take a look at some code and put all this together. The first thing you're going to want to do is install the LaunchDarkly Cloudflare Edge SDK. This SDK is a special SDK that understands that the data is synchronized within your Cloudflare worker to the KV. So it can go straight to the KV and get data rather than having to go back to LaunchDarkly. So it removes even that tiny bit of latency that might be involved in getting flag data. I've installed that and required it here. I'm also using it to do some interesting things within this worker. One of the things that I'm doing is I'm injecting all of my client-side flag values directly into the head of the document as that response comes back. What that allows me to do is actually then use it as a bootstrap for initializing LaunchDarkly. So that way LaunchDarkly initializes it already has all the current flag data that's pulled straight from the KV and doesn't need to go back to the server to synchronize. It will go back and check if anything's changed, but remember that value is synchronized. So it has the latest flag data. So I can do that and all of my client-side flag values are going to load immediately. There's not going to be any flash of rendering or any flash of content. I'm doing that here within that flag injector. You can see me appending an element to the head with the flag values that I then use here to bootstrap my client initializing. Another thing I'm able to do is actually replace out text. As you remember, that LaunchDarkly says, hey, or hi from LaunchDarkly in the header. I'm actually able to replace that out before the response is sent back. Now, imagine if you're doing A/B testing. You're not going to want to do this on the client necessarily all the time because there may be a flash of rendering, particularly on something as noticeable as that header. Well, I can actually do that as the response is being sent back. Cloudflare Workers provides me an easy way to rewrite HTML in the response. So I'm doing that by getting the flag value for that header text, and then I'm actually setting the content for that H1 element with the value of that header text. The last thing I want to show you, which I didn't show in the demo because it's really hard to show very quickly, is that I'm actually going ahead and I'm getting JSON data back from LaunchDarkly, and I'm using that JSON data to set custom headers in the response. Now, this might be something like I set custom headers depending on what the user's credentials are or things like that. There's a lot of reasons why you might want to do this, and it's really, really easy to just pull that flag data, and you can do that within a worker in the response before this ever hits the client. So as I said, there's a lot of really powerful things you can do with Cloudflare Workers, and especially when they're tied to LaunchDarkly flags, you can trigger those changes immediately just by flipping a flag and have that immediately available within your Cloudflare Workers at the edge. I know I threw a lot of examples at you in a very, very quick period of time, so I want to leave you with some resources so you can that you can use to go get additional information and learn more about it. First of all, the example code we were looking at is part of this project here under the LaunchDarkly Labs GitHub repo. It's just called cfworkers-ld. You can see the full code and examine everything that I was talking about there, as well as pull it and modify it if you'd like to as well. The Cloudflare integration has its own documentation within our docs. Just go to integrations. Under more integrations, you're going to look for Cloudflare. You'll see the full information about how to connect everything, the steps that I showed you, but obviously in greater detail. You can also see the Cloudflare Edge SDK docs within our documentation under SDKs. Under the Node.js SDK reference, you'll see the Cloudflare Edge SDK. This will give you all the information you need to know on how to integrate that within the JavaScript code in your Cloudflare worker. And finally, I created a detailed guide on how to do everything I talked about here and how I built that project and how to get set up. Everything you'll need to know within the guides in our documentation, you'll see using LaunchDarkly with Cloudflare Workers. It's a full extensive guide on everything here, so it'll give you everything you need to know to move forward. As always, you can also reach out to me at RemoteSynth on Twitter. My DMs are open, and I'm always happy to answer your questions. I hope this was helpful, and have fun learning Cloudflare Workers. Mm-hmm.